you know, I think I, as entrepreneurs, which all of us are, and you guys too, because you guys are young entrepreneurs, I think one thing that I want them to say is action items, meaning that going forward, you know, and I want them to comment on, you know, after leaving this room today, what's your recommendation about one thing that you'd like them to take action, you know, leaving this room? So I'll let Andrew say the last. Okay, Sanjeev, David, and then Andrew will do the closing.
I think what I'd like to ask each one of you to do is go back and think what you're doing, you know, look around and see what you're doing and what can make a difference in this world and what you're excited about. Don't worry about necessarily what the world is going to say. What is it that will excite you and can make a difference? And when you, if you can answer that question, I think you'll find your purpose right there. And you'll be able to do, you'll do a phenomenal job from that time on.
Great, great. Thank you. David?
I would say go home, and then every morning you wake up, make your bed. Now, why? Hold on. Because no matter what happens that day, as long as you made your bed, you accomplished one thing in that day. And you already did something. And you can go out of the house knowing you already did something. And once you start thinking that mindset, you'll start accomplishing more and more and more and always challenging yourself further. So yeah.
Great, thank you. Andrew, please.
Action orientation I would want you to do is try and find something that requires you to ask at least 5 people to do something for you. So the easiest thing to do would be like, hey, here's this organization or cause, and I want you to, like, you know, sign up, add your email address, donate $10, like something along those lines, and then just push people to do it. And then you'll find that that might be uncomfortable at first, because you have this feeling, it's like, oh, I don't want to annoy anyone. I don't want to ask anyone to do anything for me. But the thing you find out as entrepreneurs is that relationships actually get stronger when you ask people to do something for you. The misconception, the big misconception around entrepreneurship is that I can make things happen because I know lots of people. The truth is actually the reverse. It's I know lots of people because I make things happen. Like, when I started Venture for America, I did not know, like, 90% of the people that ended up supporting Venture for America. You know, I raised $20 million for Venture for America over my time as the founder and CEO. So people are like, oh, you just must have known people with lots of money, like, to get started. I did not know the vast majority of those people. But then you go to them and say, hey, this is what this is what I'd like to accomplish. This is my vision. Like, here's how I'd like you to help. And then people step up. So just find something that requires you to ask 5 people to do something for you. It can be big or small. And then see how that feels. And then what's going to happen is you're going to find it uncomfortable, but it's going to get more and more comfortable by the 5th person. And then if you're ever in that situation again, then when someone's like, hey, I need someone to do something, then you'll do something for them. And then your relationships end up getting built up over time.
Well said, and that's, please help us in giving them a round of applause, right, for all the great comments.